and insects, means you have a look on them or you observe them. How do you bring those comedies and lives to those insects which we never like to see?
Well, I've always thought that children, especially, well, you're too tall now, but otherwise the Shota ones generally look at insects more than they look at things like birds, because birds are far away. So I think they would identify with children more. Everybody's been bitten by ants. And I find that there are a lot of connection or similarities between insects, birds, animals, and ourselves. And for example, ants have a totalitarian society. So do we. And some birds are very naughty and they go and have several wives. Some may birds do that. So there are a lot of similarities between what we observe in nature and ourselves. And I make a connection between those. Like my first book was Crow Chronicles, where all the characters are birds, and they all reminded me of certain types of characters. So I cast all the characters were birds. And another book I did was Altufaltu, The Lightning Lines of Altufaltu. So I had a lot of fun because all the characters in that book were monkeys. And they were monkeys based on people I knew and maybe didn't like so much. So this was it was a soap opera. It was a complete sort of soap opera between was this little bungar called Altu Fatu, who was a complete vagabond. He was hooked on cough syrups, and he falls in love with a princess called Rani Beauty, who is the daughter of a clan chieftain, Mankeka clan chieftain in Delhi. And then there's a whole lot of tamasha that happens when they run away together. They elope, and she's already been betrothed to somebody else, to some other Bimla chap who's getting after them. So but the characters were again based on people I knew. And I also knew that, you know, even these characters recognize themselves in the book. They can't take me to court and say, sir, I'm this monkey in this book. The moment they say that, don't say, if you're saying you're a monkey, what is your complaint? So, but you see, there are a lot of similarities between the insect world and animal world and our own existence.
You have written many books. Which one is your favorite amongst them?
I think your first book will always be sort of slightly extra special, which was The Crow Chronicles, which is about this bird, this bird book I was talking to you about. And the other books that I liked very, very much was Faces in the Water. That is about female infanticide. Now that was a difficult subject to do, you know, the killing of baby girls at birth. That was a very difficult, sort of challenging subject to do. And I sort of thought that, you know, how can one write a book like this for children, because it's such a grim theme, it's a horrible theme, how can you do it? And I was just thinking about this, and then I thought that, you know, I have two sisters, and one is older and one is younger, so I always say, you know, rose between two thorns, so, but then I thought that supposing they had not been around, what kind of a life would have I lived had they not been around? And the moment I thought of that, the whole story fell into place. And I could put in a lot of fun and, you know, frolic and happiness in even a story of that grim nature. So that was one of the nicer ones I thought I would.
So I have a question. Most of your books are humorous and are full of comedy. So from that part of comedy and humors, from that to female infanticide, which is a huge topic in our Indian society. So, sir, how you, means, you wrote first humors, then came on this huge topic, female infanticide. Was there some problems which were faced for?
No, see, there are all these issues that make you very angry and which you want to write about, and this was one of them. Because actually the story started off when I read a news item in a paper about a similar sort of case that had happened somewhere in Haryana or whatever, and amongst a very well-off family. It was discovered that this happened. So it made me very angry, and I said that, you know, I've got to write a story about it, children should know that this kind of thing can happen. And but at the same time, you don't want to lose that sense of humor. Because if you can keep that intact, even in a story like this, it's all for the good for this, even the story, because it becomes more readable. Otherwise, if you don't have humor, if you don't have a little bit of lightness of fun, you know, you drown your reader in misery and unhappiness and depression. Who wants that? There's enough of that anyway. So, but yeah, these are issues that make you very angry. That how dare this such a thing happen? How can it happen?
Yes, yes.
Were you an avid reader by being a child? Can you share some incidents about it?
I was made to be an avid reader because in school, you know, as I told you, I had two sisters. One was older, the older one was a reader from day one. And you know, school holidays used to start and used to come home from the library with heaps of comics, saying, "Up to yehi padhenge." She used to look at them and say, "Put them away. I've got a reading list over here for you, starting off with Charles Dickens, Walter Scott, nothing less than 500 pages. You will read these books. If you have a problem, you come to me, I'll sort them out. Don't understand a word, look at the dictionary, make a list, use those words next time you write something." And I started doing that, I had to do that. So giving a car, you've got to do it, so you do it. And then I found that I was enjoying these stories. And people like Charles Dickens and all that, they can be dreary and all that, but they give you a grounding in your English, in your language, that no amount of grammar could have given me. I used to do terribly in grammar, but okay in writing. So it's, and then the reading, then the habit developed. And even at home, my parents used to read all the time. We were lucky that at the time of our growing up, there was no TV, there was no internet, there was no these phones or anything like that, there was no distraction. So you had to perforce read. And so we started, and then all those classic books I loved, I still could read them, you know, Three Musketeers, Count of Monte Cristo, all those old fellows, they give you a solid grounding in English. And they have very good stories. So after that, then the habit is spent on.
Did you have any aspirations while writing or reading? Like if you were reading, then you wanted to become like some author or wanted to write like the author wrote?
I never wanted to be an author, actually. I never thought I would be a writer ever. It was my sort of, it was perforce plan B. I wanted to do automobile engineering and design. But I had a few health issues and the doctor said, "No, you would just throw that out of the window, that's not going to happen. You get a desk job or something like that, that's the only thing you can do." And the only other thing I was interested in was writing, and it was, you know, in writing. So that was my plan B. I said, okay, might as well then try and write articles and things like that. And I was lucky, I had other interests also. I was interested in photography, I was interested in birds, natural history, animals, and cars. The interest in automobiles didn't die out or anything like that. So I could include all those aspects into writing, which made it easier because you're writing something what you know. And so that's how the writing part came. I started with articles and then somebody said write a book or whatever. I said what, write a book. But then I thought about it and then these ideas about these birds, because they kept reminding me of characters. So I sat down and wrote Crow Chronicles.
Did you face any ups and downs while starting to write a novel or being an author?
Oh yes, yes. In the first, when you start off, you know, say you're writing a book, you know, it sort of initially gave me this idea that now I could take as long as I like, 5 years, 10 years writing, I'm writing a book. Nobody can say anything to you, you're writing a book. So I started writing a book, and after 2 years I was done with about one.